Dear friends, welcome to Learning About. In this video, I'll be solving the reasoning ability questions from the previous sessions and previous year papers of TCS NQT. Now, as you know, in the cognitive ability NQT, you have verbal, reasoning and numerical ability. So numerical ability videos you can find in our channel. Link to those videos also in the description below. So in this video, I'll be solving about 11 reasoning ability questions, all different types of questions. So in total, you will have 30 questions, and there are no negative marks as far as the TCS NQT is concerned. There are no negative marks, and you can expect the reasoning ability questions from these topics. So you can pause the video to look at the details. Now we will move on to the questions. So the first question is a linear arrangement question. So there are six people who are standing in a queue. So let's look at the information given. So the first information is Q is between U and P. So you can write U, Q, P or P, Q, U. Both are possible. Okay, when they say Q is between U and P, both are possible. Then they say S is just before T. So S is just before T. Okay, right now we can't combine these two. Now let's take the next one. R is just before U. So when you say R is just before U, now this PQU is not possible. Only this is possible. R is just before U. And U is ahead of S with two persons in between. So we can easily make a guess. Q and P are in between, and then U is ahead of S. So S and T. So now this is the arrangement for the six people. Now the question asked is, who is standing at the last place in the queue? That is, T is standing. That's answer option 4 for question number 1. The second question, it's a alphabet series question. We have to find which term is wrong in the series, right? Now for convenience, we can write down these alphabet positions. So here we know R is 18, S is 19, P is 16, H is 8. Now you don't see any connection between the given letters here. Okay, but let's just look at the next one. Now U is 21, W is 23, U is 21 again, N is 14. Now what is the connection? R plus 3 is U, and S plus 4 is W, and P plus 5 is U, and H plus 6 is N. Okay, so let us see if we are having any the same sequence. Now U plus 3 is X, and X plus 3 is A. Now when I say X plus 3 is A, now X is 24th letter, 25, 26, and then again you are starting from A. So that's what I meant. A is the 27th letter. Then A plus 3 is D. So all of them are right. Then S plus 4 is W, W plus 4 is A. Then A plus 4 is E. So far correct. Now E plus 4 is I. Now that is also correct. Okay. So far everything is right in the sequence. Next, P plus 5 is 21. That is P plus 5 is U. U plus 5 is Z. Okay. So that's correct. Then Z plus 5 is E. That is also correct. Now E plus 5 is J. It should be J, but it is K. So D-A-K-G is the wrong one. Now let's not worry about the last letter. Okay. So answer option 2, D-A-K-G is the wrong term in the series, alphabet series. The third question is a relationship based question. Also, it involves a certain kind of code. So in relationship based question, what we have to remember the basic is that people belonging to the same generation, you keep them in the same horizontal level. So brother, sister, cousin, etc. in the lowest level. Next level, father, mother, uncle, aunt in the next level. Then grandfather, grandmother in the next level, just like a hierarchical diagram. Okay, now I'm not saying that if you don't do this, you will not get the answer correct. You will get the answer correct, but this makes it a lot of convenience for us to solve the problem. Okay, now let's look at the given statements here. The first one says Q dollar M. Now that means, just look at here, it says A is the sister of B. So I can write Q is the sister of M. Then you have M dollar P. So M is the sister of P. Next, P at C. So if you write A at B, means A is the son of B. A at B means A is the daughter of B. So P is the daughter of C. P is the daughter of C. So these three, Q, M, P, are siblings. Okay, so three sisters, and Q is they are Q's daughters. So I'm sorry, C's daughter. Q, M, P are C's daughter. And then it's given next, she hash H. So that means she is the wife of H. So she is the wife and H is the husband. Next it says H and R. So that means H is the son of R. H is the son of R. Then R percentage or modulus, whatever you can call it. So R modulus Z means R is the husband of Z. So R is the husband, and so Z is the wife. So they are the grandmother and grandfather of Q. You can also interpret that way. Now we have to say which of the following statement is not correct. Now H is the father of Q. It is thus correct. Okay, because Q and P are siblings, we already told, and C is the mother and H is the husband of that mother. So H is the father of Q and P. So H is the father is correct. Now Z is the mother of H. That is also correct. And R and Z are the parents of H, and Z is the mother. That is also correct. Now Z is the mother-in-law of C. So since Z is the mother of H, naturally she is the mother-in-law of C. That is also correct. Now, so what must be wrong? Fourth one must be wrong. So that's the answer for the question. So four. Now you don't even have to verify. You can just move on. But if you want to verify here, R is the maternal grandfather. What is R? R is the father. R is father's father of Q. So that means R is actually paternal grandfather. R is paternal grandfather. The answer is answer option 4 for question number 3. Now the fourth question. See, in this question, they are mentioning about height and the weight. Okay, but if you see, the question is only about the height, and you have to arrange them in descending order. So you can ignore wherever weight is there. You can ignore that statement and just look at only where you need the height. So the first statement, it says Q and R are shorter than U. So between Q and R, we don't know the relation, but they are shorter than U. So you are writing in the descending order. So U and then Q and R. Then we have S is taller than R. Okay, S is taller than R. So S can be here or here, wherever. We don't know. We have to just wait. S is taller than R. Next it says, next statement says T is shorter than S but taller than U. So T is taller than U but shorter than S. So we have this order, S, T, U, Q, R. Then it says P is shorter than T but taller than U. So that means S, P, T, U and Q. Between Q and R, we don't know, right? And they are in the descending order. Now the question is, who is fourth from the top in terms of descending order? So we have S, P, T, U. So fourth from the top is answer option 1. Answer option 1, fourth from top. Now question number 5, cube. So you have a sheet given. Now this is folded into a cube. So this is, you have to use visualization here and see which comes opposite to the percentage symbol. Okay, percentage or okay. Now you can imagine a cube like this. Now let this be the face. Okay, let's say I'm facing Y. Okay, and when you fold, on top you have A. On top you have A. And on the side, okay, that is to your right, you have the hash. Okay, and if you look at to the left, right, you have the plus. That is, left of Y, you have plus. Then, on the back side, you will have dollar. On the back side, you will have dollar. That is, opposite of Y, you will have dollar. Then, so you have hash comes here, and then in the bottom you will have percentage. In the bottom you will have percentage. The question is, which comes opposite to percentage? So percentage is in the bottom, so A is in the top, right? So that's the opposite. So answer option B, A is opposite to the percentage symbol. Answer for question number 5 is B. It's a very simple question, but you should have the imagination to do this. Now the question number 6. Now, question number 6 is a data sufficiency question. So you have a question, you don't have to actually answer the question, but you just have to check whether the given data is sufficient or not sufficient to answer the question. So you have two statements given, right? Now what you have to do is, first you have to consider statement 1 alone, whether it is sufficient or not sufficient, you have to check. Then you have to consider statement 2 alone, whether it is sufficient or not sufficient, you have to check. If suppose statement 1 is not sufficient and statement 2 is not sufficient, then you have to combine these two. Then after combining, it may be sufficient, or even after combining, it is not sufficient. So these are the possible outcomes. Now let us see. But this you have to answer with respect to the given statements here. So what are the given options here? Both statements 1 and 2 together are necessary is one option. Together also not sufficient is one option. Statement 1 alone sufficient, statement 2 alone sufficient. These are the options. Now let's look at what is the answer. So you first consider statement 1 alone. If you from statement 1 alone, what is the data you get? Now you get that the rate per kilometer is rupees 11 rupees. So that means if you are traveling 121 kilometers, you will have 11 rupees. But then there is a fixed charge. But we don't know what is a fixed charge. So can we calculate this value? We can't calculate. So statement 1 alone is not sufficient. Statement 1 alone is not sufficient. Now let me consider statement 2. Now what happens with statement 2? Statement 2 says there is a journey of 35, but we don't know the rate. Okay. So 35 kilometers, I don't know the rate, and there is a fixed charge, and all that comes to 835. Okay, now I don't know. Now from this, can I get, you know, like the, even if I substitute that 121 kilometers in the second option for distance, okay, now the distance is given as 35, but can I calculate the rate per kilometer? And because I'm not, as of now, I should not consider statement 1. I have to consider statement 2 alone. So statement 2 alone is not sufficient because there are two unknown variables. Okay, though there is a complete equation, there are two unknown variables. So statement 2 is not sufficient. Now what I have to do, I have to combine statement 1 and 2. Now if I combine statement 1 and 2, what do I get? So for 1 kilometer, the rate is 11 rupees. And then you have 35 kilometers travel. This I am taking from the second statement. And from the first statement, I'm taking the 11 rupees, and then the fixed charge is what we have to calculate, and the total is 835. Now, if you solve that, you will get the fixed charge as 450 rupees. Now, from that, you can calculate the journey for 121 kilometers. So that means both statements 1 and 2 together are necessary. If you combine 1 and 2, you will get the answer correct. So answer option 1 is the answer for this question. Now, that's a data sufficiency question. Now, let's go to the next one. So this is a kind of a coding decoding or an arrangement based question. So there are 5 pairs. You have to say which 2 pairs are similar. Okay. So what happens in the first one? This M and A, they are written in reverse, and then SON is written in reverse. That is MA becomes AM. I'm sorry. MA becomes AM and SON becomes NOS. Okay. Now when you look at the second one, what happens? The middle one is retained as it is. The first two and the last two are changed. So this is not similar to one. If you look at the third one, what happens? This FA is interchanged and written as AF, and this ULT is written as TLU. Okay. Now this is similar to, this is similar to the first one. So first one and three are similar. One and three are similar. Now what about 4 and, now you have answered the question, you can go to the next question. But anyhow, for here, for better clarification, I'll just do this. Now here what happens? Now this last two, they are interchanged, and the first three, they are written in reverse. The first three is written in reverse, last two is written in reverse. Now this is this has got no correlation with any of the first three. Now if you look at the last one, what happens? Here again, there is no so the first two, okay, they're interchanged, and this is also jumbled. Okay, it is not coordinating, it is not in consistent with anything else. So 1 and 3, answer option 3 is the answer for question number 7. Now question number 8, it's a syllogism based question. So we have been given 3 statements, and then we can form conclusions based on that. So it's better to go for the Venn diagrams. So the first statement says all organizers are participants. See, all organizers are participants. I can draw it two ways. This is a circle. Okay, this is a circle organizers, and all organizers are participants. I can draw it this way, or I can even write it this way. Okay, organizations and participants overlap. Okay, so this is my first preferred diagram and this is my second preferred diagram. Okay, but mostly we go for the first preferred diagram. Now let's try to draw this. So all organizers are participants. Then some organizers are managers, so which means this will overlap like this. Some organizers are managers. Okay, then it says all managers are females. So again, all managers are female. You can draw like this overlapping or like this. Okay, so all managers are female. Now this circle is female. Okay, so this is manager and this is female. Okay, now let's look at the conclusion. Now some participants are managers, that is correct, because participant circle and management circle, as you can see from the manager circle and participant circle, they are overlapping. They are one over the other, partly at least they are overlapping. So answer is, so first conclusion is correct. Second conclusion, some female are participants. The female circle is, it is overlapping with participant circle, so that is also correct. The first two statements are right. No female is an organizer is not correct, because female is overlapping with organizer. Female is overlapping with organizer. Okay, even if you go for the second preferred diagram, still female will overlap with organizer. So statement 3 is wrong. Statement 4, all participants are female, that is also wrong, because all participants are not female, only some participants are female. So answer for this question is only conclusion 1 and 2 follow. Only conclusion 1 and 2 follow. That's the answer for this question. Now, ninth question, it is a kind of an analytical reasoning question. So such questions are asked often in companies like Accenture, wherein, so it is like a HR executive job, wherein you are given a criteria for selecting candidates into interview. So you get the profile. Based on the profile, you call them for the interview. So this is that kind of a question wherein some criteria is given for selecting a homeopathy doctor in a hospital. So what are the conditions? One is, the candidate should have a BHMS degree with 60%. Second is 5 years experience in rural area. Third one is good knowledge of local language. So three conditions. But they're also giving three alternate. In case BHMS degree is there, but there is no 60%. If it is less than 60, in that case, if the candidate has got MD with 55%, that candidate will be referred to the CMO, Chief Medical Officer. The second option, that is 5 years service in rural areas, not there. Okay, only 3 years service in rural or urban, but has got spent at least 5 years in rural area. Okay, not as a doctor, but just generally spent 5 years in rural area, then will be referred to the secretary. The third one, if suppose the candidate doesn't have a good local language knowledge, but has got Hindi, working knowledge of Hindi, then will be referred to the hospital management and so on. Now let's look at the question. How the question is asked. So you have the candidate by name Jaswinder, who has completed BHMS with 52%, which means he is not satisfying the first condition. What is the first condition? He should have 55. He is not satisfying the first condition, but he has got MD with minimum 55%. So that means he is satisfying the second alternate condition. Okay, he is satisfying the second alternate condition, this one. Okay, now he has got 6 years remote village and Hindi local language and working knowledge of Hindi. So he has satisfied conditions 2 satisfied, condition 3 satisfied. Now condition 1 alone not satisfied, but that candidate has satisfied this alternate condition. So which means he will be referred to the Chief Medical Officer. That's answer option 4 for this question. Answer option 4 for this question. Question number 10. So you have people speaking various languages. People speak Russian as represented in triangle, Spanish in rectangle, square, American, Indian, circle. Okay, the question asked is how many people can speak American and Russian. American is square, Russian is triangle. So common between square and triangle, so this is the square and this is the triangle. Common between square and triangle is this area, 8. That's all. Now, this is a repeated question in TCS NQT, this kind of a Venn diagram based question, where, you know, like one overlap over the other, then they ask question based on this American and Russian languages here. Answer is answer option 2, question number, answer option 2 for this question. Now, coming to the last question, it's a direction based question. So, direction based question, please try to draw a direction guide like this, that will be helpful even for a simple question like this. This will be very, very useful. So here what happens, a man is walking 7 kilometers south. Okay, so he's going towards south 7 kilometers and then turns to his right. So that becomes the west. He's traveling the west. After walking 4 kilometers, turns to the left and goes 10 kilometers. So now he's again, which direction he's facing? He's facing south. That's answer option 2. So if you have queries on the questions that I have solved, you can ask, you can put your questions in the comment section below. Even if you have some other question, not in this video, okay, which is not in this video, you can also put those questions. And if you have any questions, any queries related to TCS NQT, you can ask those queries also in this video. And we have also put videos related to TCS NQT, how to apply for the different variants and all that. So you can also look at that video. That video, the link is in the description below. If you found this video useful, click on the like button and share it with your friends. And if you have not already subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe to the channel. And thanks for watching the video. Have a great day.